Hey, yo, what's happening, everybody? Hey, what's going on? What's been happening? Let you know what's been happening. What has happened is been a long time coming, I guess, for some. Been hearing about it. Finally has happened. Would say unfortunately, but at the same time, based off the allegations and, of course, the video that has been seen, shown of the actual events. You know, P. Diddy, Puff Daddy, Sean Combs was arrested. That's the news. That's what's going on right now. Been hearing about it. Been speculations about it. It has happened. Sean P. Diddy Combs was arrested Monday in Manhattan amid ongoing lawsuits alleging abuse, and months after a pair of federal raids that targeted him as a subject of sex trafficking investigations. He was arrested in New York, and they charging and trying to charge him on sex trafficking and racketeering. And a few other things, I'm sure. But what they're saying is the hip-hop mogul was taken into custody based on a sealed indictment filed by the U.S. District Court for the Southern District of New York. Those specific charges are not disclosed. The indictment is expected to be unsealed today. Combs is a music mogul, music icon, self-made entrepreneur, loving family man, and proven philanthropist who has spent the last 30 years building an empire, adoring his children, and working to uplift the black community. That's a question. But this is what his attorney is stating. So I'm letting you know what they're stating. But, of course, this stuff is questionable in public opinion. And based off his actions and things, it's still questionable. But this is what his attorney has made. He is an imperfect person, but he is not a criminal. That's what his attorney said. To his credit, Mr. Combs has been nothing but cooperative with this investigation, and he voluntarily relocated to New York last week in anticipation of these charges. Please reserve your judgment until you have all the facts. These are the acts of an innocent man with nothing to hide, and he looks forward to clearing his name in court. That's according to his attorney. Sean Diddy Combs charged with sex trafficking. Combs' arrest follows a spat of legal woes for the Bad Boy Records founder. He faces multiple lawsuits filed in recent months claiming the music mogul raped or sexually assaulted several alleged victims over the course of decades. Combs has denied all allegations against him. Combs was dealt a double whammy in his ongoing litigation battles earlier this month when singer Don Richardson and Michigan inmate Derrick Lee Cardillo Smith pursued legal actions. Richard, formerly of Bad Boy Records girl group Danity Kane and trio Diddy Dirty Money, sued Combs on 21 accounts of sexual assault and battery, sex trafficking, gender discrimination, and copyright infringement in a lawsuit filed September the 10th, a few days ago. She claims the producer stole her work, withheld payment, and subjected her to inhumane working conditions which included assault, groping, and false imprisonment over the course of nearly a decade. The day before Richard's lawsuit was filed, Cardillo Smith was granted $100 million in a default civil suit judgment for an alleged 1997 sexual assault, which the convict sued for in June. In response, Combs filed a pair of emergency motions on September the 12th to dismiss the multi-million dollar judgment, as well as a restraining order granted in the case. Additionally, in May, two women who claim to have been sexually abused by Combs in the mid-90s and early 2000s both sued the rap mogul for the alleged assault. Now, if you don't know, once again, P. Diddy has been arrested Monday by federal agents and been indicted on sex trafficking and other allegations, including racketeering. But that's what's being said today. Arrested yesterday. Of course, we have a bunch of thoughts about it. Say it's been going on for decades, so it's not nothing new, really. Especially if you know and if you listen to rap and if you know the history of rap to this point. And it's bad to say. It's kind of sad to say. I mean, it's kind of disgusting, to be honest with you. The fact that this has been ongoing for decades, they say. And it's not a secret because you hear it in the lyrics. You see it in the actions. You see it in the videos. You kind of see it in the everyday characters and acts and behaviors of these artists. And it just comes to a head at some point in time. It do come to the light, believe it or not. And this being an example, a man of his stature, because of his stature, being that famous, rich, and popular, was able to do these things and get away with it and still be rewarded for it and still be praised and still be celebrated for these acts to go on until someone decides that they no longer want to put up with it and no longer be afraid and no longer fear the consequences of going against or speaking up against these things when it comes down to people that are famous, rich, and popular and of a celebrity status because of the backlash that most of them believe that they're going to get, the blackball, the discrediting, the anything negative that can come against or that can be contributed to anybody who choose to stand up and speak out against the wrongdoings of quote-unquote powerful people. P. Diddy being one of them. So they're saying at the time, Diddy admitted to no wrongdoing, but months later after CNN released video of the rapper striking and dragging the Me and You singer in 2016, he later came out and said he makes no excuse for his behavior. Of course, we've seen that video. Before the video release, there were allegations made by Cassie about that abuse. He said it never happened. He denied it just for the video to come out to show exactly what he basically quote unquote lied about, saying that it didn't happen just for the video to show that it did happen. Then he recant his statement basically saying that he was sorry about it. He made no excuse for his behavior, yet he lied about that said behavior not even existing or not happening. Of course, to cover himself. But now, all these other allegations that came about, and I hope this just goes to show, and I hope more people, to some degree, stand up for or stand up against wrongdoing, period. That's kind of like, that's really what's going on in the black society and black community right now. Some refuse to stand up against wrongdoing, and they refuse to speak out against wrongdoing. Yet, they accept the wrongdoing, they complain about the wrongdoing, and still they can glorify and uplift those that are doing the wrongdoing, which is crazy when you think about it. And yet they want things to change in the black society and black community. Yet with an insane mind that so many of them has come to have, they glorify the wrongdoing that they know is a detriment to their very existence within their society and within black community. It almost makes no sense. It shows you the insane mind that people has built up all this time. It shows you, hate to say it, the quote-unquote mental illness that exists within black society as a whole. It's crazy. But they glorify and uplift individuals because of the status, the money, the power, the fame, the popularity, the idolizing of these individuals. That's enough for black society in some eyes to overlook all the wrongdoing that these individuals do just because of those things. Famous, rich, and popular. They overlook all the wrongdoing. But once again, P. Diddy has been arrested on sex trafficking and racketeering and a slew of other accusations that happened Monday. Today they are still releasing information. They say when reached for comments regarding the case, the Homeland Security investigation spokesman said in a statement, at the time, New York executed law enforcement action as part of an ongoing investigation with assistance from Homeland Security, Los Angeles, Homeland Security, Miami, and other local law enforcement partners. The search was part of an ongoing sex trafficking investigation in New York. Several people have been interviewed by investigators about allegations against Combs regarding sex trafficking, sexual assault, and other alleged offenses, according to NBC News. This is Sean P. Diddy Combs arrested in New York, in Manhattan, upon the indictments of sexual trafficking and rape allegations and racketeering. Of course, it's been going on for a few months. So they finally made a statement and said that he was arrested. Not saying he's been charged with anything, but they indicted him. And upon that, gave them the authority to go and arrest him. So that's what's happening right now. Sean P. Diddy Combs. And what are your thoughts about it? Now, you have to look past the celebrity status. Because I know a guy right now that I just heard about who just got time locked up right now for sexual assaults. He's not a mogul. He's not a rapper. Wrongdoings. You do the crime, as offensive as the wrong as that crime is, you do that, what do you think should happen? And it shouldn't matter whether you're rich, popular, famous, to think that you can escape it. You shouldn't. And unfortunately, in public opinion, people idolize these individuals so much that they're willing to look the other way when they do all these wrongdoings that has a direct or indirect effect on you, your community, and the society that you live in, especially the black community, black society, because we tend to look the other way when it comes down to criminal activities. That is a detriment to us growing and building a better community, for lack of better words. That's been going on forever. It's been going on for too long, matter of fact. And yet we think that we should be respected and looked at in a higher, brighter light when all you see is darkness, utter confusion, and just craziness that goes on when it comes down to black society. So what do you think about this? Sean P. Diddy Combs has been indicted as of yesterday. That being Monday. So let me know what you think about it. It's Righteous But Ruthless Minds. I'll be back with a few more. relating this subject in any other manner or matter or situation that involves black society, black community, music, anything that involves the black community as a whole. So I'll be getting back to you. If you like this content, man, go ahead and hit the likes. Go ahead and subscribe. Go ahead and share. Got more to come. Righteous But Ruthless Minds. I'm out of here.